The interior of Siberia is known for its rugged topography and cold climate. Yet, in the same area, there is something which few people have ever heard of, active volcanoes. While not as active as Kamchatka's volcanoes, a specific Siberian volcano produced one of the largest effusive eruptions on the planet of the last 10,000 years. The eruption in question resulted in 111 square kilometers of land via a 70-kilometer or 43.5-mile-long lava flow being buried in molten rock. Although hard to access, the volcano which produced the aforementioned eruption around 7,000 years ago is known as Jom-Bolok. The Jom-Bolok volcanic field can be found in south-central Russia, just 63 kilometers north of the border with Mongolia. This field consists of 9 volcanic cones and a vast field of lava which has almost all formed in the last 15,000 years. You might note that this unusually placed volcano is relatively close to the deepest lake in the world, Lake Baikal. This is not a coincidence. The reason why Baikal is so deep and elongated relates to its formation. In this section of Russia, the crust is rifting or spreading apart to the northwest and southeast. This created a grouping of thin zones in the crust, allowing for magma to erupt via paths of least resistance, forming a number of young volcanoes. As for Baikal, it represents the center of the rift zone and could be thought of as an unusually deep but wide crack in the Earth's crust which has since been filled in with water. The first eruption from the Jom-Bolok field formed the Medvedev cinder cone and an associated lava flow, but we do not know the age of this feature. The first feature we do know the age of formed 14,300 years ago when a volume of magma erupted adjacent to a series of vast glaciers. As lava fountains were ejected to a height of several hundred meters, cinders of rock fell back to the ground, forming a series of two cinder cones. As a vast amount of lava was erupted from these vents, it slowly traveled to the east as it was pulled in that direction by gravity since the overall land elevation slowly decreased in that heading. Eventually, the eruption ended and the recently erupted lava had filled part of a canyon. Over the next several thousand years, these two vents were heavily eroded by wind and water, which is why they do not today have the distinguishable shape of typical cinder cones. In 5180 BCE, the volcano erupted again, but this time resulting in a several-year-long eruption. As a series of new vents ejected a large quantity of molten rock, the vast rivers of trachy-basaltic lava slowly advanced across the landscape. They traveled 10, then 20, then 30 kilometers distant, still continuing eastwards. By the time the eruption had ended, the newly deposited lava flow measured 70 kilometers or 43.5 miles in length. In total, 111 square kilometers or 43 square miles of land have been covered via 7.9 cubic kilometers of volcanic rock in the fourth largest effusive eruption on the planet during the last 10,000 years. After a period of inactivity, a cinder cone erupted at Kropotkin, creating a fresh layer of newly deposited molten rock in around the year 1130. This lava flow also filled in sections of glacially carved valleys covering 4 square kilometers and 0.2 cubic kilometers of molten rock. Since then, no additional eruptions have occurred. Overall, this unique and scenic volcanic field seems to produce a large volume of effusive eruption about once every 4,500 years. If it was to erupt again, another cinder cone forming eruption would be expected along an implied series of fissures in the ground which are marked on the screen. Such a new eruption would once again send a long river of lava to the east over a series of weeks to months, starting wildfires and covering old lava flows with newer molten rock. If such a long-reaching lava flow was to travel beyond 16 kilometers, it could begin damming or changing the paths of several major rivers, causing havoc downstream. However, the main danger from such a future eruption would be toxic gases that are heavier than air and travel downslope. A large volume of hydrogen sulfide, sulfur dioxide, and carbon dioxide in a hypothetical future eruption will be funneled into the adjacent series of valleys, causing lethal concentrations of this toxic gas at areas up to 100 kilometers distant. Thus, the people who live there would need to be evacuated during such a hypothetical future event.